بسم الله، الحمد لله، والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا المصطفى محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وبارك وسلم. Today, alhamdulillah, we have our last lecture for our series Under the Shade of Arrows, which we started at the beginning of the summer holidays. And as we come into the last few weeks of the summer holidays, this is our last lecture, which is called Submission to Allah. And it will be done by none other than our Sheikh, Sheikh Ubaidullah, who, mashallah ta'ala, whose father is a scholar, a well-known scholar in Bangladesh, and not just any scholar, but is a renowned scholar by the name of Muti'ur Rahman, hafidhahullahu ta'ala wa ra'ah. And alhamdulillah, I hope the Sheikh does not mind me saying that this shows the piety of the scholars as well, that they are able to raise their children in a way that they cling on to al-Islam and onto the Sunnah and the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, which shows the husn, the good way, the good tariqah of the tarbiyah of this great scholar who is renowned, hafidhullah ta'ala wa ra'ah. And the Sheikh himself, mashallah ta'ala, is mutakharrijan, graduated from Medina University, alhamdulillah, and he, everyone knows, many people know in our area, the beautiful qira'ah of the Sheikh and his masjid, and people call from our area, as a matter of fact. Some of you in the audience, I know you, they leave this area to go to the Sheikh's, and I don't blame them a single bit, because his qira'ah is so beautiful. And he has, mashallah, dirasat in a number of different qira'at in Quran. And of course, this is from the virtues of our Sheikh that we have today. And indeed, we must give credit to his father, Muti'ur Rahman, hafidhahullahu ta'ala, for raising such a beautiful person and who we can benefit from, inshallah ta'ala. And I hope the Sheikh does not, wala nazaqi ahad Allah, inshallah ta'ala. We hope the Sheikh does not mind that I introduce him that in that way, inshallah ta'ala. And without further ado, inshallah, I'll hand it over to Sheikh Ubaidullah. Barakallahu fi.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. وأصلي وأسلم على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين وخاتم النبيين نبينا محمد عليه أفضل الصلاة وأتم التسليم. أما بعد، today إن شاء الله تعالى we're going to speak about submission to Allah سبحانه وتعالى. And submission to Allah سبحانه وتعالى, in Arabic we say التسليم لله. التسليم لله, and التسليم comes from الإسلام, because when we say الإسلام means الاستسلام لله بالتوحيد. This is Islam meaning استسلام لله. You submit to Allah سبحانه وتعالى, and this is meaning الانقياد والخضوع, that you accept. And you accept this deen, you accept the commandments of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and you accept worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and to be obedient of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and following the messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and you stay away from shirk, and al-ma'asi, the sins. This is the submission to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and this is the meaning of al-Islam. And when Ibrahim alayhi salam was asked, and Allah said to him, Aslim, إِذْ قَالَ لَهُ رَبُّهُ أَسْلِمْ, his Lord said to him, submit. قَالَ أَسْلَمْتُ لِرَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ, and I have submitted to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Lord of the creations. So الاستسلام أو التسليم, submission to Allah سبحانه وتعالى, this is the meaning of the religion of Allah سبحانه وتعالى, and this is the main purpose of Islam, and this is روح الإسلام أو foundation of the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Like how Ibn Qayyim rahmahullah, he said, إِنَّ مَبْنَى الْعُبُودِيَّةِ وَالْإِيمَانِ بِاللَّهِ, the foundation of worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and believing in Allah, also وَكُتُبِهِ and believing in his books, وَرُسُلِهِ and messengers, this is the foundation is عَلَى التَّسْلِيمِ. The foundation is عَلَى التَّسْلِيمِ, that you submit to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in everything without any questions, وَعَدَمِ الْخَوْضِ فِي تَفَاصِيلِ, and you don't question and ask about the details and the wisdom behind every single issue or mas'ala. This is meaning at-taslim lillah subhanahu wa ta'ala in every single matter. It starts from the greatest, which is at-tawheed, and onto the all of the religion, even the imatatul adha an al-tariq, even when you remove something from the street, this is the lowest iman. طيب. So this is at-taslim lillah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And also he said, Ibn Qayyim rahmahullah, he said, وَلِذَلِكَ لَمْ يَحْكِ اللَّهُ سُبْحَانَهُ عَنْ أُمَّتِ صَدَّقَتْ نَبِيَّهَا وَآمَنَتْ بِمَا جَاءَ بِهِ أَنَّهَا سَأَلَتْهُ عَنْ تَفَاصِيلِ الْحِكْمَةِ. He said, there is not the nation that they used to, that believed in their messenger, and they believed in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and their messengers, and they used to ask and questions to their messengers about the reason or purpose to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala or any small minor masail. They never used to ask. Like we have best examples, the Sahaba radiallahu anhum, they never used to ask to Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, why is it like that? Or what's the reason behind that? Except if the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told them without any question. And whenever they asked, like how Bani Israel, they asked Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, made it harder for them. Because it was against the foundation of Islam, that when you accept this Islam, that you don't ask to the religion of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to the messenger, or you make the questions. لا تسألوا عن أشياء. You don't ask and you don't go into that. You don't say, why is it like that? Like how Ahlul Bid'ah, the people of innovations, they became innovator because to ask is, that's not, doesn't make sense. Like how Al-Mu'tazila wa Al-Asha'ira, they ask about Asma wa Sifat. And they prefer the Aql, the mind, more than the Al-Naql, which is Al-Qur'an or Sunnah. So this is against At-Taslim Lillah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala, the submission to Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala. And people, or Muslims, darajat, levels in the Taslim. Some of them, they have the highest rank of at-taslim, like how after the Prophets alayhi salatu wassalam, مثل Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu, when he submitted to the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he never questioned when he said, when he was called as-siddiq, truthful, because he believed and to Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam in every single matter, even if something was unbelievable, like al-Isra wal Mi'raj. As soon as he heard from other people, not from Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he heard from disbelievers, Kuffar Quraysh, that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam went to, just last night, he went to Bayt al-Maqdis, and from Bayt al-Maqdis, he went to the heavens, and then he came back the same night he came back to Mecca. And they thought Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu will be like them. But Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu responded, that فَإِنْ قَالَهُ, if he just said it, so if he came from his mouth this, then فَقَدْ صَدَقْ, then he spoke the truth. Look at the submission to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and we never can imagine that, like how can someone respond in this case? But because of the iman billah subhanahu wa ta'ala and submission to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and his messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, it came from his mouth easily, and this is the tarbiyah. And taslim, this is tarbiyah imaniyah. Mas'alat al-taslim, mas'ala, like the issue of taslim, submission to Allah, is mas'ala imaniyah. You cultivate and you give tarbiyah to yourself how to submit to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, so you can higher your rank of at-taslim, because people are darajat. Some people, they submit in some matters, but they don't submit and they don't do taslim in other matters. طيب. And وهكذا. So you cultivate yourself, you teach yourself, you learn how to submit to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, even if he was against yourself, like how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا كُنُوا قَوَّامِينَ بِالْقِسْطِ. طيب شهداء لله ولو على أنفسكم. Be just and submit to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, accept the truth ولو على أنفسكم, even if he was against yourself. ولو على أنفسكم أو الوالدين, even if he was against your parents, أو الأقربين, أو even if he was against your family or tribes. طيب, so this is تربية إيمانية that we should learn about and we should hear and we should read the seer of الأنبياء عليهم الصلاة والسلام, and we should read the seer of الصحابة and العلماء, so we learn how to submit to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala all the time. We might say, like, we are Muslims, then if we talk about submission to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and we are Muslims, we submitted to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and we believe in Him and we worship Him, لكن we need to say, is it in every single matter in our lives or not? And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said about this taslim, not the word of taslim, لكن this is the actual meaning of taslim, when He said in Surah Al-Ahzab, وَمَا كَانَ لِمُؤْمِنٍ وَلَا مُؤْمِنَةٍ إِذَا قَضَى اللَّهُ وَرَسُولُهُ أَمْرًا أَنْ يَكُونَ لَهُمُ الْخِيَرَةُ مِنْ أَمْرِهِ. So Allah says, whenever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanded with something, there is no way for mu'min or mu'mina, for believer, man or woman, إِذَا قَضَى اللَّهُ وَرَسُولُهُ أَمْرًا أَنْ يَكُونَ لَهُمُ الْخِيَرَةُ. They have choice that they can accept it or not. Because you are believer, you submit to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and you don't have choice. Because like how we are worshipper of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala اضطراراً, like we worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala falsely. Like we are worshippers of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. All of us, all of mankind, worshippers of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. طيب. سواء we believe it or we didn't believe it. So we are worshippers and servants of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So we have to make ourselves worshipper of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with our choice, ikhtiyar. طيب. And this is the submission to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You have to accept the truth. You have to accept the religion of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You have to accept what Allah has commanded you. طيب. If you don't follow, then still you are worshipper of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but you didn't submit it to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So you didn't higher your rank in تسليم لله, submission to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And also Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in many ayat of التسليم, when He said about المنافقين, those who doesn't submit to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He said فَلَا وَرَبِّكَ لَا يُؤْمِنُونَ. Allah, He said, by your Lord, لَا يُؤْمِنُونَ, they will not be believer. So their iman won't be completed. لَا يُؤْمِنُونَ. And this meaning, your iman will be completed if you submitted to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in every single matter, in every single thing, major or minor. And your iman will be less if you don't submit to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in one matter. So your iman will be less. So this is shows the iman, al-nas, like people are level in this matter. Some of them, they completed the iman, like how we said al-anbiya and al-sahaba, like Abu Bakr radiyallahu anhu and others, al-sahaba, they completed the iman because they submitted to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But if someone didn't submit to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in some matter, then his iman not completed. La yu'minun, and here iman, for if someone has the foundation of iman, then he's a mu'min, lakin he's missing the كمال الإيمان. He's missing the كمال الإيمان, the completed إيمان, the full إيمان. And if someone like منافقين, they're missing the أصل الإيمان. They don't have the إيمان. لا يؤمنون. طيب. But if you have the إيمان, the foundation, which is worshiping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and you don't submit to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in details matters, طيب, then this is لا يؤمنون, meaning they didn't complete their iman until you submit to Allah سبحانه وتعالى in every single matter. So Allah سبحانه وتعالى says فلا وربك لا يؤمنون حتى يحكموك فيما شجر بينهم. Your iman won't be completed, and by your Lord, the iman won't be completed until they take the justice from and the judgment from the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam, whatever happened between them, because they used to take sometimes from Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and sometimes they used to go to others because Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam might be harsh in this matter. طيب, so Allah سبحانه وتعالى said about them لا يؤمنون حتى يحكموك فيما شجر بينهم. Is that enough that you accept the judgment from Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم؟ ثم لا يجدوا في أنفسهم حرجا مما قضيت. And after they listen the judgment from Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم, they don't have anything in their heart that they displeased with this judgment. They can't have this inside their heart. لا يجدوا في أنفسهم حرجا. It's little inside your heart. You don't say it. But في أنفسهم inside their heart. حرجا مما قضي. Whatever you have commanded them or you have told them. Then Allah سبحانه وتعالى says, is that enough? ويسلموا تسليموا. And after all of that, you accept the judgment from Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم. You accept the truth and you don't have anything or any doubt inside your heart or anything like disagree or disagreement or displease inside your heart. And also after that, where you sallimu taslima, and you have to submit to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala after all of them. So look how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave us tarbiyah to submit to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in every single matter. And this ayat doesn't mean just only for kuffar, disbelievers, or only for munafiqeen, those who doesn't accept they didn't accept the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam judgment that time, or maybe munafiqeen until yawm al-qiyam. It's not for all Muslims, even for us. لا يجدوا في أنفسهم حرجا مما قضيت ويسلموا تسليما. And also Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Surah Al-Nur, when he said about Al-Munafiqeen, وَمَنْ عَلَى شَاكِلٍ Munafiqeen, and those who like them, and those who doesn't submit to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, accept sometimes the truth and sometimes they don't accept. So he said, وَإِذَا دُعُوا إِلَى اللَّهِ وَرَسُولِهِ Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, when they're being called to them, Allah and His Messenger, وَرَسُولِهِ لِيَحْكُمْ بَيْنَهُمْ to take the judgment from Kitab and Sunnah, to take judgment from Al-Wahi, إِذَا فَرِيقٌ مِّنْهُمْ مُعْرِضُونَ some of them, they will turn away from judgment from Qur'an and Sunnah. And if you look at many people, when it comes to the truth, they accept the truth, you show them the evidences from Quran, you show them evidences from Sunnah of Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam. طيب, and he was against them, their methodology. It was against their manhaj. You'll find them إذا فريق منهم معرضون. They will turn away because they can't accept it. It's against their foundation. They think this is our foundation. We have to be like this. This is our methodology. You have to be like this. Came the ayah. This is against our methodology. There is hadith, no, this is against our methodology. We don't accept it. Even they're not saying it, but they don't accept it. So that means there is a lack of knowledge and there is lack of iman. طيب. So إِذَا فَرِيقٌ مِّنْهُمْ مُعْرِضُونَ وَإِنْ يَكُنْ لَهُمُ الْحَقِّ And also Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, and when the haqq with them, when the truth with them, يَأْتُوا إِلَيْهِ مُذْعِنِينَ They will accept it straight away. And they will be very happy that we have this haqq with us. We have this evidence. This is with us. This is follows our manhaj, our methodology. وَإِنْ يَكُنْ لَهُمُ الْحَقُّ يَأْتِي إِلَيْهِ مُذْعِنِينَ So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, when he mentioned about their situation, they accept sometimes when the haqq with them and they turn away without saying anything. The mu'ridun, they turn away when they were against, when this haq against the manhaj, طيب, or the aqidah, or the understanding. So he said, أَفِي قُلُوبِهِمْ مَرَضٌ. Allah says, is there illness in their heart? أَفِي قُلُوبِهِمْ مَرَضٌ أَمْ يَرْتَابُوا, or they have doubts in their heart. أَمْ يَرْتَابُوا أَمْ يَخَافُونَ أَنْ يَحِيفَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِمْ وَرَسُولُهُ, or they're scared to accept to the truth because it will be against them. Maybe Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam will say something or will command something against them. أَمْ يَخَافُنَا يَحِيفَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِمْ وَرَسُولُهُ. And when we read this ayat, we should try to understand and we should think about ourselves first before we think about other people. Think about ourselves first. Whenever comes the truth to me, do I accept it straight away? طيب. Or I turn away because my understanding first. And then ask, if I turn away, أَفِي قُلُوب, is my, inside my heart there is illnesses, or I have doubts, أَمْ يَرْتَابُ, or I'm fearing that this truth might be against me or my manhaj or my understanding, that's why I'm turning away. أَفِي قُلُوبِهِمْ مَرَضٌ أَمْ يَرْتَابُ أَمْ يَخَافُونَ أَنْ يَحِيفَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِمْ وَرَسُولُهُ بَلْ أُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الظَّالِمُونَ. So that means, these people are wrongdoers, ظالمون. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, so the true believers should be like, إِنَّمَا كَانَ قَوْلَ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ. The true believers should be, إِذَا دُعُوا إِلَى اللَّهِ وَرَسُولِهِ لِيَحْكُمَ بَيْنَهُمْ. When they're being called to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to judge between them. So who's the truth? He said, المؤمنين. What do they respond? أَنْ يَقُولُوا سَمِعْنَا وَأَطَعْنَا. We heard and we obeyed. Not just heard, we heard and obeyed. And we followed this truth. أَنْ يَقُولُوا سَمِعْنَا وَأَطَعْنَا وَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْمُفْلِحُونَ. So they are successful. They will be successful in dunya and the akhirah. And this is the description of mu'mineen. They always accept the truth from al-kitab wa-sunnah. They accept the al-haq from al-kitab wa-sunnah and they submit to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala this truth. And submission to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala could be in aqa'id, in believing masail, طيب, in tawheed or in bab al-uluhiyyah, bab al-asma' wa-sifat. طيب, worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone, stay away from shirk, أو باب الأسماء والصفات, that you believe that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has names, best names and lofty attributes, أسماء الصفات العلى. And also we stay away from ta'wil and tahreef, to change the meaning or change the understanding of as-salaf. طيب, and we accept the understanding of al-khalaf, those who came after this best generation from al-Sahaba, al-Tabi'een and Atba' al-Tabi'een and A'imma al-Arba'a, four Imams. Those who came after and they misunderstood and they changed the meaning of asma al-Sifat. طيب. So could be this in Taslim, in this Masail, Bab al-I'tiqad. Or Taslim could be in an Abwab, also in Ibadat. So مثلا in the salawat, you submit to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in salawat. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala calls us every single day 5 times, hayy ala salah, hayy ala al-falah, come to the prayer and come to the success. طيب. You answer yourself like, how much do I have that submission to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this ibadah, in this great ibadah, every single day 5 times, whenever I could hear the adhan, whenever I know this time will be time of salah, Do I run? Do I go to the masjid? Do I get up from my bed and go and pray Fajr? Do I get up and then I make wudu and go to the masjid and pray in the masjid? How do you accept this ibadah? Do you accept like how Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to run to the masjid? And Aisha radiallahu anha said, whenever he used to hear the adhan, he used to go from the, like he used to leave the house, كأنه لا يعرفنا. He like, he doesn't know us. The way he's leaving the house, when adhan is giving, he used to leave it like he doesn't know us. We are strangers. كأنه لا يعرفنا. Are you, like, do you think you're like that? Do you think you have this taslim lillah subhanahu wa ta'ala every single salah? Every single day, you submit to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and you come to the, you accept the, you answer the adhan and you come to the salah and pray in the masjid. طيب. So, this is the taslim in ibadah. Also in the mathalan, in the zakah. You know that this time I have zakah. Do you submit to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and you give the zakah straight away? At the same time, you have to give zakah and you don't delay your zakah. طيب وهكذا إن سائر العبادات. Do you accept مثلا الحج مثلا أو الصيام? Do you submit to Allah سبحانه وتعالى and you fast properly month of Ramadan and you do a حج when you have ability من استطاع عليه سبيلا أو you keep delaying and delaying and delaying. طيب. So this is in عبادات generally. Also in معاملات. For example, interest. Do you submit to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that you earn halal and you stay away from haram? Do you submit to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that you don't accept the riba interest even if it was hard for you, even if it was against like your understanding or if you're against, you're like, you need to take this riba but you don't want to take it because you submit to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, taslim lillah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So a taslim in many, in every single thing we do in our life, in aqa'id, what we believe, and in ibadat, in mu'amalat, also in usrah, in with our families, طيب, you submit the truth. طيب, how do you, even how to give tarbiyah with the children, there is submission to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, how to give them, you strive hard to give them tarbiyah. طيب, also in every single akhlaq and mu'amalat, in every single thing that there is, تسليم لله سبحانه وتعالى. And Allah سبحانه وتعالى said, ومن أحسن دينا ممن أسلم وجهه لله وهو محسن. He said, ومن أحسن, meaning who's better than, and this who's meaning لا أحد أحسن. No one better than who's ومن أحسن ممن ومن أحسن دينا ممن أسلم وجهه لله وهو محسن. So no one better than who accepted this Islam and this religion and he submitted to Allah سبحانه وتعالى. أسلم وجهه meaning he submitted his face meaning himself to Allah سبحانه وتعالى لله وهو محسن and he محسن and he's the best and he's good and he's righteous. But with worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and in obedience of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And also submitting to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that you accept the sunnah of Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam because in the Quran Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said about the sunnah, وَمَا آتَاكُمُ الرَّسُولُ فَخُذُوهُ. Whatever Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told you to take, so you take whatever commanded, whatever he commanded, then you take. فَخُذُوهُ. And this is command, is for wujub, is an obligatory commandment. That you take whatever Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam gave you or commanded you. And وَمَا نَهَاكُمْ عَنْهُ. And whatever he prohibited, then فَانْتَهُوا. And you stay away from it. فَانْتَهُوا meaning you stay away from it. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, أو نبي صلى الله عليه وسلم he said لا ألفين أحدكم متكيا على أريكته يأتي الأمر من أمري مما أمرت به أو نهيت عنه فيقول لا ندري ما وجدنا في كتاب الله اتبعنا. So many commandments from Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam, like from in the ahadith. So he's Nabi sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, shouldn't be someone like he's sitting on his sofa like Arika, or he's sitting and then he's saying whatever we found in the book of Allah, we follow it and we leave the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam sunnah, like how people of innovation they do. Like in a taslim, that you accept whatever in the book of Allah and sunnah of Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he tests us in taslim. Sometimes he tests us in our ibadah, like how we submitting to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in worship, like in the salah, how we accept in this salah and we coming to the masjid running to pray and we don't miss the salawat. Or sometimes he tests us in how to be patient to stay away from sins. Right? This is submitting you. You know this is haram, so you submit to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and you stay away from this sins. Or sometimes with hardships and calamities, how you submit to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. For example, death or fear or jua, like hunger. Allah tests you. Then what do? You submit to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and you be patient. Right? This is all from submission to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We have many good examples or best examples in Quran. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said about the taslim lillah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And also we have seer from as-sahaba radiyallahu anhum about the submission to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So when Nuh alayhi salam, as you know, like his son was a believer. He didn't believe in Nuh alayhi salam. And until last moment, Nuh alayhi salam was calling him, Ya Bunay, O my son, irkab ma'ana. Come to us and accept the Islam and ride this ship, because he was dying and drowning. So Musa, Nuh alayhi salam, he said, irkab ma'ana wa la takum ma'al kafirin. Like some riwayat, irkab, and some riwayat, irkab ma'ana wa la takum ma'al kafirin. Don't be with the disbelievers. So still he didn't accept the truth even that last time. And this is how Nuh alayhi salam gave tarbiyah. Like even the last moment, and he knows he is not accepting my da'wah, he's not accepting after 1,000 years, except 50. So 950 years, he didn't accept the da'wah. He didn't accept, he couldn't give him tarbiyah. Still he's trying the last moment, he might accept after he's seeing this adab. طيب. And this is how you strive hard to give tarbiyah. Even your son or your daughter not listening to you, you accept the truth. And give da'wah and you submit to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and be patient and giving da'wah. So Nuh alayhi salam didn't stop. After that, when he died and he was amongst disbelievers, so he called, قال نوح إنه ربي إن ابني من أهلي. Nuh alayhi salam called Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and he said, Oh my Lord, my son is from my family, min ahli, wa inna wa'adaka al-haq, wa anta ahkamu al-hakimin. Like, you promised me that you're going to save my family. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, Ya Nuh, innahu laysa min ahlik. He's not from your family. Even if he's your son, he's not from your family. Innahu amalun ghayru salih. His actions is not righteous. He didn't do good deeds. That's why he's not from your family. فَلَا تَسْأَلْنِي مَا لَيْسَ لَكَ بِهِ. Don't ask me something that you don't have knowledge. So Nuh alayhi salam, it was difficult from his son, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanded him not to ask. And he said to him, he's not from your son. He's not your son. لَيْسَ مِنْ أَهْلِكَ. He's not from your family. And don't ask me for this again. And look at the submission of to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So he said, قال ربي إني أعوذ بك أن أسألك ما ليس لي به. I seek refuge that I'm asking something that I don't have knowledge about. وإلا تغفر لي وترحمني. And if you don't forgive me and have mercy upon me. And he's a prophet after da'wah, 950 years. After all this time, yeah? Still he say, وإلا تغفر لي وترحمني. If you don't have mercy upon me and forgive me, أكون من وإلا تغفر لي وترحمني أكون من الخاسرين. I will be amongst losers. So look at the submission to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, even if he was against his desire that he loves his son. And this is how naturally the parents loves the children. But still, it was taslim lillah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we have also example with Ibrahim alayhi salam. When Ibrahim alayhi salam, as you know, when he was commanded to slaughter his son, beloved son Ismail alayhi salam, and he asked him, and both submitted to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Ibrahim and Ismail alayhim as-salam, and they said, اِفْعَلْ مَا تُؤْمَرْ سَتَجِدُنِي إِنْشَاءَ اللَّهُ مِنَ الصَّابِرِينَ. So Allah praised them, and he said, فَلَمَّا أَسْلَمَا. When they submitted to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they submitted to Allah azza wa jal, and they accepted without any question, اِفْعَلْ مَا تُؤْمَرْ. And they started until Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala changed this commandment. So, and we have other examples when Ibrahim alayhi salam left his wife in Mecca with Ismail, and he was a child. And no food in Mecca, no one used to live in Mecca, no inns, no jinn, no one in Mecca, and no water, nothing to drink. بِوَادٍ غَيْرِ ذِي زَرْعَ. He left in a place that there is nothing, no zara, nothing to eat. عِنْدَ بَيْتِكَ الْمُحَرَّمِ, next to the بَيْتِكَ الْمُحَرَّمِ, the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Ibrahim alayhi salam, he left her, Hajar alayhi salam, with his son Ismail alayhi salam, and he was a child. And he left them without telling them the reason that he's leaving. And look at the submission to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from Hajar alayhi salam, when she was asking, and this is how naturally she's going to ask, like, why are you leaving us? This is naturally, but she doesn't know what's going on. So Ibrahim alayhi salam left them, and he started walking without looking at them, without saying anything. So ya Ibrahim atatrukuna, you are leaving us without food. We are in غير ذي زرع. There's no food, there's no drink, there's no anyone living in this place. Then in the end, she realized there is something definitely. Allahu amaraka bihada. Did Allah command you to do this? Ibrahim alayhi salam didn't look back or say anything. Just he moved his head. So look at the submission to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and this is amazing. إِذَنْ لَا يُضَيِّعُنَا. So she said, so Allah will not lose us, Allah will not leave us. Because Allah has commanded, so Allah will not leave us. Put that in your heart, and put that in your practical life. When you think this is haram, and I have to submit to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and this is haram, because whenever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made something haram, definitely there is harm. Why don't you say, إِذَنْ اللَّهُ لَنْ يُضَيْعُنَا, that Allah will not leave us, we're not going to die. Because when Allah made something haram, definitely there is hikmah behind it. Even if you think there is benefit, if I get this money, this haram money, then I might be better situation. I'm not going to struggle. I'm going to pay my debt. طيب. But you should think, إذن الله لا يضيع. Because it's haram, then Allah will not leave us. And this is how you submit to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah has, when Allah tested them and they passed the test, so Allah testing us in every single matter in our life, like how Allah tested them. And Allah, like how he said in the beginning of Surah Al-Ankabut, powerful ayat, alif lam mim, أحسب الناس أن يترك وأن يقولوا آمنا. Have people thought that they will be leave, that they will be left without Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make them trials and calamities? As soon as they say آمنا وهم لا يفتنون, they're not going to be tested, they're not going to be in trials and calamities. وَلَقَدْ فَتَنَّ الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِهِ, Allah has tested those before them, prophets عليهم الصلاة والسلام, الصحابة رضي الله عنهم، عند علماء، عند الأمة، سواء باوز ولقد فتنا الذين من قبلهم. Why the purpose? فلا يعلم أن الله الذين صدقوا. To know who's the truthful, who's إيمان is true إيمان. Who's this تسليم? He has true تسليم. صدق. He was truthful in his submission. When he submitted to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in his Islam. And who wasn't? فلا يعلم أن الله الذين صدقوا ولا يعلم أن الكاذب. Also, like if even we have many examples about Anbiya alayhi salatu wasalam, or even Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Like we listen, like there are many examples that from the Sahaba, like how they used to accept this al-Taslim and how they used to submit to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Once, Nabi sallallahu alayhi wasallam stood up in minbar and he said, "Ijlisu, all of you sit down." And a Sahabi, his name, so a Sahabi, his name, Abdullah ibn Rawaha, radiallahu anhu, he was too far from Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He heard Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to say, "Ijlisu," sit down. And he wasn't in the masjid, he was too far from the masjid. But he heard Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam say, "Ijlisu," sit down. Just sit down. Right? And he sat down in his place. He wasn't in the masjid. He was far from masjid. He wasn't next to the khutbah to, "Oh, Prophet is going to start khutbah, let me sit down." No, he was proper far. But he just heard Ijlisu, sit down, and he sat down. So Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in honor of the riwayah, Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam after that was walking and he saw him. Masha'anuku. What happened to you? What's wrong? Why are you sitting? He said, "سمعتك تقول اجلسوا." I heard you to say اجلسوا, sit down. So I sat down. فجلست. فقال له النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم, النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم said, "زادك الله طاعة." May Allah increase you in obedience. Allah. So look at the submission to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Even normal Sahabi, like even many like this woman, old woman. When Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, and this is all this ahadith sahiha. So Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, when she was asked, like, can old people go and enter Jannah? So Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, they're not going to enter Jannah, the old people. So she could ask that time, like, how come? I believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I believe in you. And I do righteous deeds, and like that's not fair. She could have asked that. That's not fair that I'm doing everything, and I submitted to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and you saying in the end that old people not going to enter Jannah. She didn't ask. She started crying. When Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that old people will not enter Jannah, she started crying, and she didn't ask because she. As soon as she heard from Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, she accepted and she started crying. There's no way then. What can I do? I only have way that I can cry. So Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam after that told her that when you enter Jannah, you're not going to be old; you'll be young. And this is from a normal sahabiya, old sahabiya. Also when the Sahaba radiallahu anhum, like how Arab, they used to have khamr, alcohol, all the time. They used to have, like drink alcohol. It's like, day, like many of Sahaba, they used to drink all the time, day and night. This is how. And one, like Khalid al-Walid radiallahu anhu, obviously this is in the Kutub al-Sir. When Ali radiallahu anhu got married, to Fatima radiallahu anha, daughter of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And the day he's getting married, he prepared a camel, Ali radiallahu anhu, because he's getting married. And the camel for Arab times, something like very great, like something great, like they're going to ride the camel. So Khalid bin Walid radiallahu anhu, he was drunk. Like he had alcohol. So when he came and he slaughtered this camel, and he prepared for his wedding, like his nikah. So when he came, Ali radiallahu anhu, like, why did he do that? And he starts saying, like, you and your father is my servant. Khalid ibn Walid replying like this. So he's not understanding what's going on. طيب. This is how Arab they used to drink. Also, if you know, like, before, this is obviously before the Al-Khamr was haram. And also, like, Kuffar Quraysh, when they came to, before they come to battle of Badr, they said, let's go to Medina. First battle with the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was battle of Badr. So Abu Sufyan and Abu Jahl, they said, let's go to Medina and we'll drink alcohol there, and all of Arab hatta tasma' bin al Arab, and we'll so basically they show the proud, and so we'll drink alcohol. Basically, this is the point, that we'll drink alcohol there, and all of Arab will hear what we did to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and his companions. So Arab, they used to drink alcohol a lot. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made it haram for them slowly. But in the end, it still wasn't haram, and they used to drink alcohol. So Anas radiallahu anhu said, I was giving them in the cups to drink. So Anas radiallahu anhu said, كنت أسقي أبا عبيدة وأبا طلحة, like, I was giving أبو عبيدة وأبو طلحة رضي الله عنهم وأبو ابن كعب, like, from alcohol. So فجاء آت, a man came, random man, no Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, no from one of the greatest صحابي أو بكر أو عمر, random man. فجاء آت, a man came, was walking, and he said, ألا إن الخمر قد حرمت, أو إن الخمر قد حرمت, the alcohol is being haram now, Allah made it haram clearly. طيب. So straight away, فقال أبو طلحة, أبو طلحة رضي الله عنه, he said, قم يا أنس فأهرقها. Oh Anas, take it and throw it. Leave it now. And then whole Medina, the town of Medina, it was, on the street was alcohol. Look how they submitted to this commandments without questioning, oh, this, who is this man came? Right? Without asking, is it true? The Prophet ﷺ said this. What is the ayah? What is the evidence? Show us this. يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا إِنَّمَا الْخَمْرُ وَالْمَيْسِرُ وَالْأَنْصَابُ وَالْأَزْلَامُ رِجْسٌ مِّنْ عَمَلِ الشَّيْطَانِ. He didn't recite the ayah when he was going. He just said, إِنَّ الْخَمْرَ قَدْ حُرِّمَتْ. That's it. And straight away, the believing in that and submitted to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, something that they love, something that they drink all the time. And they straight away, they throw it, and then, and whole Medina was full of alcohol, the street of Medina. So, so this is how Sahaba radiallahu anhum took the tarbiyah from Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, tarbiyah imaniyah, and how to submit to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in every single matter, in aqeedah, in ibadah, in mu'amalat, even was against themselves, even something that they love, طيب, they used to submit to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Also in ayat al-hijab, when it was revealed, because hijab wasn't obligatory. Al-Arab normally they used to, like, I'm talking about normal women, the even though it was kuffar, they used to cover like something. But the neck used to be shown, or like faces, and like the hair, some of them. So this is how Al-Arab used to be. Or some of them, even the Arab, they used to cover their hair, because this is how fitrah. But they used to show their faces and necks and hands and arms. Like this is used to be normal. Like, it wasn't, because it wasn't obligatory. So Umar radiallahu anhu made dua to make it bayin lana bayan and shafi, to make it clear in this masail, like in khamr and in hijab. So when he was revealed this ayah, يا أيها الذين آمنوا قل يا أيها النبي قل لأزواجك وبناتك ونساء المؤمنين, say to your wife, O Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, say to your wives and وبناتي, your daughters, ونساء المؤمنين, and believers women, طيب, يدنين عليهن من جلابيبهن. So They used to cover their head. This is how it used to be. So they, Allah said to take from the head scarf and put it on their faces and to cover their faces and necks, right, and chest, little bit from chest. So this is how was revealed. Right? Because يدنين عليهن من جلابيبهن, there is something on top of the head. So they take from this scarf to put it on the face and the neck, and this is how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed. And this is the Mufassirin rahimahumullah said about this ayah. So he said, خرج نساء الأنصار, the women of Ansar, like Medina, they came out from the houses, كأن على رؤوسهم الغربان الأكس. So they covered everything. We can't see anything after that. It wasn't slow processing. طيب. It wasn't something that, okay, slowly we'll submit to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We're not used to this. We're not used to wear this clothing. We're not used to cover everything. It looks so weird. طيب. No. Submission to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that you accept the truth without asking, without, even if it was against yourself, against your desire, against your hawa, you accept it. And this was Nisa al-Mu'mineen at that time. And this is how should be our daughters and our wives and our sisters should be like that. And there are many examples of at-Taslim from as-Sahaba radiallahu anhum. And I like to end with the story of Sulaym, Sulaym radiallahu anha, when her son passed away, and she didn't, and her husband Abu Talha radiallahu anhu was he was outside, so he didn't know, and he came from far away, and his son passed away, and she didn't tell Abu Talha radiallahu anhu when he came to the in the house. And why she didn't say? Because he came back from like long journey, so she didn't say anything. And they had relations, so she served him first food, and Abu Talha radiallahu anhu had food, and then they had relations in the night. In the morning, next day, and Abu Talha radiallahu anhu didn't know. So next day, Sulaym radiallahu anha said to Abu Talha radiallahu anhu, that if Allah has given you something and he's taken, are you going to be upset, or are you going to be displeased? So Abu Talha radiallahu anhu replied, like, how can I be upset? I'm making a shot, so how can I be upset that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala takes something that he's given, amana? Like, he's giving us something and he takes it. Like, why would he be upset? So she said that our son passed away yesterday. So Abu Talha radiallahu anhu got very angry, like, how can you not say that to me before, and you gave me food and we had relations, and then you're telling me now, because my son passed away and you're not telling me? So he went to the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam straight away to tell the story, like, why would this happen, like, why would she do that? But already al-wahi revealed to the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam about this, and Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam was when he heard the, obviously when he came to Abu Talha radiallahu, he said, لعل الله أن يبارك لكما في ليلتما. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give you barakah, bless, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless you in this night. طيب. Even if you lost something, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give you barakah. And Rawi said, that فرأيت لهما تسعة من الأولاد. I saw they had 9 sons after that. تسعة. No, just Allah took one and gave him better. 9 sons. طيب. من الأولاد. And then not just sons. He said, كلهم قرأوا القرآن. All of them, they used to be حافظ القرآن, memorized Quran, and they used to be knowledgeable. So look at the barakah of this righteous woman. Look how she submitted to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in hardships. Look, like how I said, is you submit to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sometimes in obedience of Allah, so good deed. You submit to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to stay away from sins, and you submit to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in when you have calamities or hardships. So she submitted to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and look at the barakah Allah has given them. 9 sons, and they're righteous, all of them, and they memorize Quran, they have knowledge of book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us amongst those who submit to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive our sins and accept our good deeds. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us ikhlas and get rid of the al-ma'asi wa-s-siyyat. Forgive us. وصلى الله وسلم على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك، أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت، استغفرك وأتوب إليك.
جزاكم الله خير، بارك الله فيك وأحسن الله إليك شيخنا. الحمد لله we benefit from that lecture. Yes, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept it from the Shaykh and to accept it from all of us. Ameen, ya Rabbil Alameen. This is a very important subject. Taslim lillahi subhanahu wa ta'ala. And if there are any questions, inshallah ta'ala, raise your hand, inshallah ta'ala, we can take some questions now. The Shaykh comes.
This is when it comes to the sins, so there is not, like, there is something that is doubtful matters, which is the shubuhat, and there is way how to get at the shubuhat, and there is way another, which is a shahawat. So something that you do, for example, you do as like, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala keep us away from sins, lakin say if a person does a sin, we need to know, does he do with the shubha, like, does he have doubt in this matter, right? Then he has to know about this matter, he has to accept the truth from the Quran and Sunnah, and this is most likely Ahlul Bid'ah, and they have to accept the truth from Quran and Sunnah, from the Sahih Ahadith, and learn from the ulama, right? So it doesn't come with the with other issue when someone does a sin out of shahwa, following the desire. He knows this is haram, he knows, he accepts, and he knows this. There is ayat, there is ahadith talking about this haram, lakin he does because of shahwa, following the desire. So in this in these matters here, ulama said many ways to make taslim lillah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Like, for example, you said, like, do sins or doesn't wear hijab or does some sins. So ibadatullah subhanahu wa ta'ala first with fara'id and voluntary keeps you away from this following the desires. And ulama always, they say at-ta'abbud lillah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So whoever find the sweetness of ibadatullah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he'll be away from following the desires. And this is how, if you look at the sahaba radiallahu anhum, how they used to accept the taslim, their situation always, they used to have ibadat. So they used to be attached with ta'abbud. So obviously after the fara'id, they used to have ibadat, مثل voluntary salawat, مثل sunan al-ratiba, salat al-witr, salat qiyam al-layl, طيب صلاة الضحى and others. And they used to have قراءة القرآن, they used to have قراءة القرآن, like reading Quran or memorizing Quran. They used to have تدبر القرآن, the understanding the Quran with the and taking reminders from Quran. طيب they used to remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala day and night. الدعاء. So this تعبد keeps you away from الشهوات. And this is the maybe best way to get rid of ash-shahawat from a person. So for example, someone listen to music because he found that sweetness to listening to that, which is sweetness in the dunya. But he found that sweetness listening to that. He doesn't know the sweetness of reading Quran and listening to the Quran. He doesn't know the sweetness when you say La ilaha illallah when you say the adhkar al-sabah wal-masa, when you recite al-Qur'an al-Karim, when you understand the Qur'an al-Karim, he doesn't know. And whenever a person start reading al-Qur'an al-Karim with understanding, whenever a person read al-adhkar all the time, like sabah wal-morning and evening, and adhkar generally, and istighfar, طيب, he will find that sweetness, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will keep him away from this desire. He will get this taslim lillah subhanahu wa ta'ala easily from at-ta'abbud. طيب, so this ta'abbud is very, very important. Like many people ask, like this is like because it happens a lot. Like many people say, like my, for example, my daughter or my one of my family members doesn't wear hijab. طيب, how can we? It's difficult because the society is different. Society, not a Muslim society. So even from between Muslims, not. They have many shubuhat, they have many shahawat, طيب. So there is no, so first, after they understand the importance of al-hijab, so they need to understand the ayat and ahadith, طيب. So because most of them, they don't know the ayat al-hijab anyways. They don't know the importance of hijab from Quran and Sunnah, طيب. So after they have knowledge about this, then they should have some ta'abbud. They should worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by obligatory and then some voluntaries from qira'at al-Qur'an, understanding al-Qur'an and tadabbur, contemplating and pondering over Qur'an. طيب. And qiyam al-layl, al-du'a, al-dhikr generally. طيب. Then inshaAllah ta'ala it will be easy for them to wear hijab because they're not going to feel that al-shahwa and they will feel that sweetness of iman more than al-shahwat. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also like how he said, وَلَكِنَّ اللَّهَ حَبَّبَ إِلَيْكُمْ إِيمَانَ وَزِيَّنْهُ فِي قُلُوبِكُمْ. Allah made iman, Allah made you to love iman. طيب. حَبَّبَ إِلَيْكُمْ الْإِيمَانَ وَزِيَّنَهُ and made a beautification of the heart فِي قُلُوبِكُمْ وَكَرَّهَ إِلَيْكُمُ الْكُفْرَ وَالْفُسُوقَ وَالْعِصِيَانَ. And Allah made you to hate الْكُفْرَ وَالْفُسُوقَ وَالْعِصِيَانَ. So all this is how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does it. Because whenever يعلم الله في قلوبكم خيرا, you have good in your heart, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala definitely will give you this good. So مسألة التعبد, this is very, very important to get rid of the shahawat in the heart, and you submit to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allahu a'lam.
Now when you're studying in Medina, did you have students that had doubts, and what was the answer of the scholars to how to deal with them? What kind of advice
would
you give
to students and knowledge about the knowledge? Basically, Omar asked is if the Sheikh, while he was studying in Medina, did he meet anyone with shubuhat? And how did the scholars deal with such shubuhat? That may have made some of these people who have these shubuhat leave the aqidah of Ahl Sunnah.
You can ask others more about it, but just I'll try to explain a few things, inshallah. So remember, staying in Medina or staying in the best place in Mecca or others doesn't mean you will learn correct aqidah, or you will accept the correct aqidah easily. If you look at the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, they were munafiqeen. With the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, with the Sahaba radiallahu anhu, the best generation, still the munafiqeen in Medina. طيب. So what about now? طيب. And you see many, doesn't mean if someone seeking knowledge, studying, that he will have correct aqidah, he will have right manhaj, he will have a good understanding, because many people, they have this, but because of many reasons, like maybe they're listening to wrong people, or they're sitting with wrong people, or they have desires in their heart, Allah turns them from this understanding of as-salaf. So you'll find that normally, and this is not new, like you'll find that all the time that when you seek knowledge, you'll find people around you like this. And you might be among one of them, and you don't know. So seeking knowledge has to be the way ulama rahimahullah they said, and there is manhaj how to seek knowledge and how to deal with them. That first you try your best to stay away from this shubuhat. You try your best to stay away from these people of shubuhat, those who have doubts. And you need to know when you seek knowledge that what's your goal. Always you remember your goal. Don't remember the something that you want to achieve. Remember the goal that you're seeking knowledge for. Why do you seek knowledge? Whenever you ask, why do you seek knowledge? Why do you go to Medina and learn in Medina, for example? Or why are you learning in UK? You're going to Masajid, for example. You're going to Sheikh. You're going to Talib al-Ilm to learn or seek knowledge. The purpose is to get rid of the jahl, so get rid of the ignorance, and to learn, to have knowledge from Quran and Sunnah first. And then, so I can act upon this knowledge, because this is the purpose of seeking knowledge. So this is the goal of Talib al-Ilm, of student of knowledge. And if you don't have that goal, if you just have other goals, right, other than this, then ulama, rahimahullah, they said, الهاكم التكاثر. Even this ayah is not for Talib al-Ilm, لكن this applies also for Talib al-Ilm. الهاكم التكاثر. Many things that you do, and is you distracts you from your goal. Because حتى زرتم, until you die, until you visit the grave, meaning until you die, you didn't reach your goal. You keeping seeking knowledge, but you're actually not seeking knowledge. You keeping looking for the truth, and you don't accept the truth. طيب. And you got distracted from the truth, from learning this knowledge. You got distracted from قيل وقال, فلان said and فلان, I said. طيب. Or you get distracted from seeking knowledge by many things, علم الكلام, talking and giving this evidence and this of debating. Yeah, you get distracted. Did Allah give you responsibility to debate? Did Allah give you responsibility to say قيل وقال فلان and فلان? Did Allah give you responsibility فلان? I have to say this person is right and this person not right. Did Allah give me responsibility? Allah didn't give me responsibility. What Allah gave you responsibility? This is your goal. Worshipping Him with ikhlas. Worshipping Him the way Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam worshipped Him. Fix tazkiyah, like you fix your heart, you pure your heart, you clean your heart from illnesses. Yeah, you seek knowledge to increase. Like how Ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah, like who is Ibn Taymiyyah? When we talk about Imam of Aqidah, Imam in Fiqh, Imam in Hadith, Imam in Lughah, Imam in Tafsir, he talks about every single ilm like he's the most knowledgeable in this ilm. This is how Ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah. And we're not exaggerating. You can read the books of Ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah and you will know more. طيب. So Ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah, when he was after this life, after this ilm with and jihad with ilm and learning, teaching, and his students Ibn Qayyim, his students Imam al-Dhahabi, his students Ibn Hajar, his students like ulama kibar, the great a'imma. طيب. When he was before he is dying, like before his death, he was saying, he was reciting Quran. He was in the jail, as you know, and he recited Quran more than 80 times, so 82 or something times he finished the Quran. And when he was in 83 or something, and he reached the ayat in end of Surah Al-Qamar, إِنَّ الْمُتَّقِينَ فِي جَنَّاتِ وَنَهَرٍ. مُتَّقِينَ will be in jannat, وَنَهَرٍ فِي مَقْعَدِ صِدْقٍ عَنْدَ مَلِيكٍ مُقْتَدِرٍ. Then he said, أَشْغَلَتْنَا عَنْكَ. He was saying to ilm that, he was saying to Quran that, I got distracted from you. And his life with ilm. So what about someone got distracted from shubuhat, distracted from people of shubuhat, desires, distracted from others here? How to deal with them? You need to know your goal. Forget about people. You need to know your goal first. And you need to always remember that the student of knowledge and listening to the student of knowledge is not going to benefit me from my to achieve my goal, which is learning this knowledge and acting upon this knowledge. And subhanAllah, Allah put barakah into ilm qaleel, little knowledge. Even if you don't have so much knowledge, little knowledge, but Allah put barakah into it. maybe this ilm will spread all of the world, and this ilm might be like people might learn from your knowledge until yawm al-qiyamah and you don't know. And many, we have many mutun like that, that people learn from this matin, and this alim, no one knew about him that time. Like, as you know, matn al-ajrumiyya in Nahu. Imam who written matn al-ajrumiyya, he threw his matn into in the sea. He threw it, and he said, if I have ikhlas in this, Allah will put barakah into it. And matn al-ajrumiyya, like if I say thousand and thousand people learning, and if I not say million people learning from this matn since Imam al-Ajrumi rahimahullah ta'ala. طيب. So you don't think about how people take benefits from you and how should I be. You think about your goal, your target, ikhlas Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, how ulama sought knowledge and how ulama took this knowledge step by step, tadarruj. And with sabr, with patience, with ulama rabbaneen, with good righteous ulama, those who teach you al-ilm properly. طيب. And inshallah ta'ala you'll reach that knowledge. How do you advise them? How do you sometimes advising them in the, when you're a student, there's no benefit. So don't think about advising more than yourself. So first think about yourself, advise yourself instead of debate. And because I've seen many people, they don't want to advise, but whenever they go into that or whenever they go to these people and try to talk and like take give and take, you can't stop yourself that time. You have to give. And you don't have knowledge. You think I'm in right. And you are right maybe, but when you give and talk and you give this answer and you take this question and you give this answer, and you might take some doubts in your mind and you don't know because you're big enough, student of knowledge. طيب. So there's many nasaih inshallah you can take, and I hope this is inshallah ta'ala enough. Allahu a'lam. Jazakallah khairan. This is enough inshallah.
Barakallahu fiqh. I think that's enough for today, inshallah ta'ala. The Sheikh has given us a lecture which is very beneficial. There's a lot of things that we can benefit, a lot of good points that we can apply into our life. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will seek for that. I thank you all for coming, Jazakum wa khairan. I thank the Sheikh for coming as well. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward him and accept from him. Barakallahu fiqh. With that, inshallah ta'ala, we conclude not only the sketch of our series,
Inshallah, our next series will be coming soon. And we always have lectures in the masjid. We weekly, the rules will start again, every Monday. Inshallah, Saturday, and 12 o'clock, and the week, every Thursday, inshallah, we will be starting again this September. So keep your ears open, inshallah, and we will let you all know when these will be restarting, inshallah. Allahumma wa bihamdika. Ashhadu an la ilaha illa anta.